So we are mistaken when we see wonderful things happening in the cosmic nature. We should know that behind these wonderful manifestations there is a controller. Nothing can be manifested without being controlled. It is childish to not to consider about the controller. Just like a very nice motor car with very good speed and very good engineering arrangement is running on this street. A child may think that how this motor car is running without the help of any horse or any pulling agent. But a sane man or an elderly person, he knows that in spite of all engineering arrangements in the motor car, without the driver it cannot move. That engineering arrangement of a motor car or an electric powerhouse, now at the present moment it is the day of machinery. But we should always know that behind the machinery, behind the wonderful working of the machinery, there is a driver. So the Supreme Lord is the driver, adhyaksha. He is the supreme personality under whose direction everything is working. Now, these jiva, or the living entities, they have been accepted by the Lord in this Bhagavad Gita, as we will know it in later chapters, that they are parts and parcels of the Supreme Lord. Mamaivamsa jiva-bhuta. Ansa means parts and parcels. Now, as a particle of gold is also particle, a drop of water of the ocean is also salty. Similarly, we, the living entities, being part and parcels of the Supreme Controller, Ishvara, Bhagavan, or Lord Sri Krishna, we have got, qualitatively, all the qualities of the Supreme Lord in mind. Because we are minute Ishvara, subordinate Ishvara. We are also trying to control. We are just trying to control over the nature. In the present age, you are trying to control over the space. You are trying to float imitation planets. So this tendency of controlling or creating is there because partially we have got that controlling tendency. But we should know that this tendency is not sufficient. We have the tendency of controlling over the material nature, lording it over the material nature. But we are not the supreme controller. So that thing is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Then, what is this material nature. The nature is also explained. The nature, material nature, is explained in the Bhagavad Gita as inferior prakriti. Inferior prakriti and the living entities are explained as the superior prakriti. Prakriti means which is controlled, which is under prakriti. Real meaning of prakriti is a woman or a female. Just like a husband controls the activities of his wife. Similarly, the prakriti is also a subordinate, predominated. The Lord, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is the predominator, and this prakriti, both the living entities and the material nature, they are different prakritis, or predominated, controlled by the Supreme. So, according to Bhagavad Gita, the living entities, although they are parts and parcels of the Supreme Lord, they are taken as prakriti. It is clearly mentioned in the 7th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita, yes, aparayam, itasu vidhi apara. This material nature is apara, yes. Itastu, and beyond this, there is another prakriti, and what is that prakriti? Jiva bhuta. So, this prakriti, the constitution of this prakriti is constituted by three qualities: the mode of goodness, the mode of passion, and mode of ignorance. And about these modes, three different kinds of modes, goodness, passion, and ignorance, there is eternal time. There is eternal time. And by combination of these modes of nature, and under the control, under the purview of this eternal time, there are activities which is called karma. These activities are being done from time immemorial. And we are suffering or enjoying the fruits of our activities.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
Yeah.